Lexi Show.
But I dropped her off, and in less than an hour or so, I got that news. Your baby's dead. How do you handle that, and you're not ready for that? I didn't get up thinking my baby wasn't coming back home.
They understood it. They couldn't read it.
Because I wasn't happy about life.
I prayed.
I can't tell by the sound of your voice if you're really in love with me.
That love God and will love me the way God loves me.
And you are.
The free spirit.
I'm blessed. I am blessed.
No,
I hurt
can't lie.
A lot of people.
If I say to you, baby, I love you, then baby, I love you. Oh, and I do. Yes, I do.
Welcome, everybody, to season 5 of The Lexi Show. I'm so glad that you could be here. Wondering where I am doing the Lexi Show right in Jonesboro, Georgia. Yes, sir. I am here at Divine Faith Ministries International. Put your hands together. I want to give a special shout out to Pastor Battle and Pastor First Lady Gwen Battle for allowing me to be here. Thank you so much. Brought somebody to the Lexi Show that I think is so phenomenal. I have been watching their ministry for years, and such a phenomenal voice. You know, I don't want to say talent, because what you have is a gift.
Thank you.
Truly is a gift. Everybody give it up for LaShawn Pate. Oh, no, thank you for being here. Now, people may know you from your songs, For My Good, But For His Glory. You know that?
Yeah.
And I remember, hey, 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 hey.
Yeah.
But I think the biggest one is that everybody knows is I Know I've Been Changed.
Yeah.
You know. I attempted that once. It didn't turn out very well.
Wait.
No. I tried to do that growl. It just didn't. Even now, it sounds a mess. How have you been, sweetheart?
I'm great, Lexi. I love you and miss you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. What are we doing? What are we trying to get jazzy for 2011? What are we doing? Talk to me.
Well, it was Mother's Day coming up. And,
okay.
My daughter treated me to get my hair done.
Okay.
And, of course, when I said pink, she went crazy. She was like, I was like, but that's my favorite color. It's Mother's Day. I'm getting what I like.
What you want. I got you. Let's talk about a little bit. You know, you have so many sisters, and your family is humongous. Oh. How many girls are there? Let's talk about that.
9 girls.
God. Are you serious?
Yes.
A lot of fighting going on when you were growing up?
Oh, my mother didn't have that. So we had to do the little nudge thing.
Oh, okay.
We never fight.
No, but we would pinch each other. Is that what you
No pinching. It's actually you actually elbowing and like.
Right. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you grew up in the church all your life?
Yes, I did. Born and raised, Church of God in Christ.
Come on here, somebody. Yeah. Come on. That's how I was raised. So it was 9 girls.
And one boy. Yes.
And we want to take a minute and talk about your brother.
Yes.
Bishop Murphy.
Bishop Murphy was like our brother / our dad.
And we're saying was because just recently,
yes,
you lost your brother.
Yes.
How old was he when he passed?
I don't know the exact age. Murphy was 56.
And he didn't want to tell it probably.
And he didn't tell us that he was that ill. So his death caught us like in a shock. And we are yet trying to deal with that. He loved us so much. That's what my mother was telling us. Your brother didn't want you to know.
Yeah.
Though he just left quietly at 3 a.m. one Wednesday morning.
Yeah. Yeah.
God came and got him.
Yeah. We just wanted to do that really quickly because
so
I know that he meant so much to you. And he was also a singer in his own right.
Oh,
so
goodness.
It wasn't just the girls that
Murphy
sang.
Pace and the Voices of Power.
Yeah.
I mean, he was my number one singer.
Yeah.
Nobody could out-sing him on that song I love to him, sing Joy to the World.
Yeah.
When he hit that Joy to the World.
How was it, traveling with all of y'all?
You got the one in the group that's the mama, and that's Phyllis. Okay. She's the third oldest. And okay. Phyllis is like trying to keep everybody together. Okay. Y'all know what mother said.
Right.
I'm going to tell mother when we get back home.
Yeah.
But we didn't have to go through a whole lot of that because it was instilled in us.
That's good.
My mother is a praying woman. And she prayed until God saved everybody in the household.
Yes.
From daddy down to the baby girl.
Oh, my God.
And
so was your dad saved at first?
No, he was not.
So your mom, a praying woman, married?
Yes.
Okay, yes. Okay.
No, she wasn't saved when they got together.
Okay.
She used to carry a gun and a 22 and a stick. You got to see the play. I'm just putting the plug in. But the play is, Nalanda has written a play about the family. But my mother used to carry a 22 and a stick going after my daddy. That's the gamble side of the family.
Is that right?
Yes.
How does a stick work in concert with the gun? I don't understand.
If one don't work, the other one will. You're going to get your man or the woman.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Somebody going to get got.
I'm serious. You know.
I love that. I love that. But you grew up in a praying household.
Oh, yes.
By the time it got to you,
oh, yes,
everybody was in line.
Yes.
Mama put down the gun.
Hold on, a few of them.
Okay.
I ain't gonna name no names, June or Melinda. They weren't quite ready for Jesus. So when they got to school, they kind of rolled their little skirt up, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
We didn't do no fans.
Oh,
but
yeah.
You put your little
come on,
grease on your lips.
Yes.
But when you get off the bus to get home, you
that's right. You got to get it right.
But everybody is in now.
Yeah.
Yes.
You've been saved all your life?
I got saved at the age of 8 and filled with the Holy Ghost at 12. And a lot of times I fail.
Okay, see. Because I grew up Kojic too, and you know, coming from, you know, a Kojic household, I get it.
Yes.
You know, and being saved at an early age, you get to know God at an
yes.
early age and all of that, being a PK and
yes.
so forth.
And you can become self-righteous. I did at some point and didn't notice it, but it happens without you even noticing.
Wow.
You know, because some of the girls in your graduation class is pregnant, you are not, and you'd be like, oh my goodness, oh, but it's building up something that shouldn't be there.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know somebody that used to go walk through campuses and say, you know, rebuke, rebuke, just self-righteous.
Are you serious?
Were you like that?
No.
No?
I wasn't that kind of self-righteousness. And in fact, it was years after I got out the house and got married and going through some stuff myself.
Sure.
Till the Holy Ghost revealed to me, you're self-righteous.
Wow. And so how did you pull that in line?
Through the Word. You know, I had to do that, even with my mistakes. I was always a girl that would get in the mirror and talk to myself, this is your fault. You did this, and you need to get it together. And I've always talked in the mirror.
When I introduced you, I almost introduced you as LaShawn Pace Rhodes.
Yeah.
So how long have you been just LaShawn Pace, back to LaShawn Pace?
Over about 6 years.
How long were you married?
I was married technically 11 years.
Okay.
Yes.
What do you see as the breakdown of the marriage?
Not communicating and money issues.
Yeah.
Those are the main two. That's what I would put. Infidelity, unfaithfulness, however you want to put it.
Okay. We're not going to, you know, go crazy into it because he's not here to defend himself or anything like that.
Oh, I would never do that.
Yeah. But, you know, there was some infidelity there.
Yes.
And how did you recover from that? How did you recover from the infidelity?
Well, I lived it a long time.
Is it something that you found out? Is it something that you kind of knew in your spirit and it just got confirmed, or?
Well, it was like blind, you understand?
Okay.
And then you get a prophetic word from the Lord in service while you're in the choir stand, and
my stomach would be upset. I would be sick because you kind of know that something's wrong.
Oh yeah, before service I had this thing in the pit of my stomach. You know how you feel like a little girl, you're getting ready to get into trouble?
Yeah.
And I had no idea, and I'm like,
what it was.
Right. So all before service, Sunday night service, I just had that feeling that something is going to happen, something is wrong. And in the service, right before the minister began to climax it, you know, that's when he called out and started ministering.
Wow.
So I was just in the choir stand down like this and I don't understand what's going on. Of course you're embarrassed.
Yes.
And after service everybody's going, we praying for you. And And that's exactly what happened. I'm not making it up. Oh, we praying for you.
Well, what was the Lord saying?
You know, I'm like,
how do you feel about that? Do you feel that God is in that, that a minister would, you know, because I'm so used to prophets nowadays just talking about prosperity.
Yes.
And the fact that you're going to get a house and
right.
that things are going to turn
yeah.
around and that you're going to the next yeah. level. But the prophets of old used to just tell you
yeah. Uh-huh, yeah.
the truth.
Yes.
Good, bad.
Yes. And after service, they did sit me down. The prophet and his wife, they sat me down on the front row. And said, this is what God was saying tonight, A, B, to Z.
Wow.
You know. And when God has given you a chance to get something right and you don't,
that's right.
It don't hit the news first. He tell you first.
That's right.
And when you don't get it right, he's not going to let the one that's trying to live righteous suffer.
Mm.
So that's just where I was. God was like, you mean business with me. And something else is going over here.
Wow.
I can't allow you to suffer
yeah.
and go through.
Yeah.
Wow.
And not be in the dark and be in the dark,
dark right.
about what's happening. So I had to go through that embarrassment and that, you know.
Yeah. And then you come from a traditional, you know,
yes,
Kojic, you know, and we don't do divorce, you know.
Right.
It just wasn't in
oh,
our
was
DNA
crazy.
To do that. So were you embarrassed?
I wanted to stop traveling, stop singing. And everything because I felt I was singing a lot. I felt I was testifying a lot.
Yeah.
And nobody would want to hear me.
From that?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Because that's how the church was. The Church of God in Christ has changed.
Yeah.
You know, from
the church in general.
Lot of, yeah, the church,
church
in general.
General.
But I can only talk about what I was raised in.
Right.
They have changed. They're not as, you know what I'm saying, just
yeah.
so hard.
Yeah.
It's more compassionate now.
Yeah.
And somebody gave me that book, Kenneth Bacon from Texas, mm-hmm. The Compassionate Side of Divorce.
Mm.
And that helped me so much. He said, you're going to get some preachers that's not going to want you to in their church
wow.
to minister and sing. But the ones that do, this is what you minister. This is what you say.
Mm-hmm.
And just come from the compassionate side of God with this thing.
Yeah.
And that's how God broke me from that self-righteous spirit.
Wow.
Yeah, I used to be judgmental and didn't know it. You know, I was the one that sit in church with my eyes in point, not with my fingers. Do you see that? You know, with the sisters going, you know, when they walk
gotcha.
In, you would defend.
I've done it.
Girl, look over. And that's wrong.
Yeah.
And it's not getting into the kingdom of God.
Right.
I mean, we want to look at big names. But you sit nudging and you judging. And he said, judge not.
Yeah.
But you want to look at the folk that's doing marijuana, ladies that's sleeping with ladies, men that's sleeping with men,
right.
but you judge it.
Wow.
Now, which one going to hell?
Wow.
All. Yes.
So that cured you?
Yes, it did.
Okay.
The Holy Ghost helped me through that.
Yeah.
You know, he helped to walk us through processes and thoughts of murder, thoughts of revenge. If I don't get them, I can pay somebody to get them. That's just where I was.
Yeah.
And that's witchcraft.
Yeah.
Mm. When you wishing something bad on somebody else. It's not the will of God. God took all of that out of me, and I began to love. You know, I went through the whole thing. I was fearful, didn't want to be seen by myself, or I thought I'd be hurt. Because the other individual is hurt as well.
And, you know, we were talking about infidelity. There's you are taking some ownership in your part
yes.
of the breakdown
had,
as well.
I had some reason. I had, because my brother, like I said, my brother was like my king.
Yeah.
So when I got married and the girls had to go somewhere and sing, mm-hmm. and he wanted me to go sing over here, and I'm like, my brother told us we got to go here, Zach. Okay.
Right.
You know.
But you're not considering your man.
Right.
Wow.
A whole lot of that. You know, I was at fault with that.
Yeah. Are you guys cool now?
Oh, yes.
Friends
so
now?
So. Yes.
Yeah.
Amen.
That's my baby dad.
How many children did you guys have together?
We had two girls.
Two girls?
Yes. Zania, the firstborn, who passed away about 10 years ago. Yes. February 21st. I'll never forget it.
Let's talk about that for a minute.
Okay.
I remember when it happened.
Yes.
What happened exactly? I was never clear on what happened to Zania.
From the beginning stages, like I said, it was rough. I did not want them to be around my ex. I didn't want you know, so, and I was carrying my second child during the divorce,
okay,
several months pregnant. And then the decree came down that after I had her, they both would have to go to visitations. But the visitations were hated. And a lot of things was taking place instead of them being with who they were supposed to be with, because that individual was out of town, mm-hmm. they are with somebody else in the family.
Gotcha.
And they didn't like that. Right. So, and every time they came, they were screaming, hollering, going up the driveway. How long can you endure that? Your child, I mean, literally screaming, "Mama, we don't want to go, you know." So I would cry. God, you got to help me. God, you got to help me. Prophet Martin would come to town. Different other people would come. God said he's going to help me. And I'm like thinking, okay, God's going to help me all right, because he's going to remove this person. But he came and got my baby. So you have to be careful what you're asking God for.
Yeah.
I want you to help me. Get me out of this thing. So he got me out of it. But he took my child, took our daughter, the firstborn.
How did she pass?
Broken heart. When she would go to school every day, she was at a private school earlier, an old National Christian Academy. And when she left there, you know, went to a middle school. Every day, from every school she'd been to, they would pick at her because of her size. Beautiful girl, mm-hmm. but the children did not like her for whatever the reason. They would call her fat, "You're ugly. Who would want to have a baby with you?" And then when she passed, I went to the school to see, talk to the teachers. Nobody wanted to talk to me. And when they showed me where she was sitting, the class is here. There's a circle around with her desk in it by herself. I was crushed as a mother that nobody would talk to me. That's the first thing. And then her desk was by itself. They wouldn't let her go to the restroom when she needed to go to the restroom. So there was problems with that, you know what I'm saying? If you don't go to the restroom, different, it's crazy.
You know, that was how many years ago?
That was about 10 years.
And we're just now talking about bullying.
Yeah.
Bullying is the new buzzword right
yes.
now.
Yes, it is.
But your child was being bullied.
She was strangled in the hall by two girls one day. When I was coming to pick them up, she got in the car and could hardly speak. And I'm saying, what is the matter? I can't tell. Two girls just strangled me up. And my baby was like, when we going to get them girls? You haven't even started school yet, but she's, that's how she was. And I was like that myself, but I'm like, why would you just strangle her in the hallway? Why would you? She got a Valentine date for everybody in the class. I had to go buy 60-something Valentine. We at night trying to fill out, let's finish it in the morning. So we're in the car before she get out of the car to get, trying to finish from Zania. Happy Valentine, from Zania, happy. And before the end of the day, you see all those cars in the trash can. That hurt her. My daughter died of a broken heart. She did not die of overweight. She was not diabetic. We didn't eat like that. We ate at wrong times. I minister
like
about
I
that too.
Yeah.
Because when you're in the church, we don't eat breakfast a lot.
No.
You know, when I was little, we did. But then, but anyway,
long
story short,
yeah.
She died of a broken heart, because when we got to the hospital, the Lord had a nurse to come and say, "You need to fill out some papers, because they don't know why this baby died."
Jesus.
Wow. And I looked at her, I said, "Well, you get the papers, I'll sign and do it, whatever it was I needed to do."
Was she sick or was it sudden?
It was sudden. It was sudden. The night before, she thought of one of her girlfriends who passed away, Dorothy, and she said, we in the car going home, we was leaving Uncle Jay's house, because mm-hmm. every Monday night is family nights for us.
Okay.
We at somebody's house. We just called out the address. We're going to 3791, we going to 5250 or whatever.
That's cute.
So we was there, and she was sitting on the floor, and she said, "Mama, my heart hurts." And I looked at her and I saw a glow just across her head. Immediately, I knew what it was. I said, sitting there looking at her, I said, "I rebuke death in the name of Jesus." That's all I could say.
Yeah.
I said, "Well, baby, sit up on the chair for a little while, mm-hmm. then we'll leave and go home." So on the way home, we're riding down the road, and she says, "Mommy, I miss Dorothy." I said, "Okay." I said, "I do too." So I began to sing the song, "I Know the Lord." I don't know why. She came, picked right up. "I know the Lord, we'll make a way." Girl, that Wednesday, because that was a Tuesday. that Wednesday, the Lord, after I dropped her off at school, I get them up every morning. So she got up and she went, like, as she usually do, didn't want to go to school.
Sure.
So it was like something perked her up. And she started getting ready and everything. I was like, what is wrong with her? But I dropped her off, and in less than an hour or so, I got that news. Your baby's dead. How do you handle that and you're not ready for that? I didn't get up thinking my baby wasn't coming back home.
No. Divorce? Mm. Your daughter?
Yes.
You know, your brother?
Yes, my dad.
Your dad?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've heard about your dad.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
And you're still here.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Want to get married again, Sean?
I got married again.
When? Where? Where? What happened? What's going on?
Sean Pace Holmes.
Okay.
But it took a while. He never got the papers. You know, I was told that, you know, you're not going to live long. Long story short. So that it was crazy.
You heard that you weren't going to live long. Who told you that? Was that
the young man I married.
The young man you married,
yes,
said that you weren't going to live long?
Yeah, they're going to find you dead in this house.
Jesus.
And I heard that more than 3 to 4 times. So.
Why would someone, why would you? Because I have a ministry of helping people. And I got a stick, too. That's how I help.
I'm definitely not a fighter.
You're not a fighter.
I've never been a fighter.
Yeah, I'm in health.
I can't even swim and do that.
I do that well. I do that well. I have that ministry.
No. You sound like a gambler.
Oh, I don't play. I sound like your mama. What inside of you said that I have to take this? Or what inside of you said, keep talking to me like that?
Nothing said that. I was like shocked when I first heard
it. But you stayed. Because he said it more than once.
The day that he said those words, it was like three days that how the Lord got me out of that.
I got you.
Yeah, I think I had been there 2 years.
Wow.
And they would never get the papers. Then when we went to go get the papers, you got some money? I was like, I got to pay for the license too.
Sean, how did you make it through all of that?
Damn. Trying to pray. Damn. Pray, and I was sickly in the midst of all of that. I mean, in and out of the hospitals.
Yeah.
Just so one morning I was laying on the bed and I was crying and I said, only you know how to get me out of this.
Yeah.
Right.
I can't do it.
Yeah.
And it wasn't a minute. I hear from upstairs, get all your pretty little beep, 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 and get out.
Yeah.
Man. I was like, Shock Tolliver. Changed his mind, you know, said that was some good times.
Sure.
So then they run down the stairs and trying to block, don't leave, don't let. So my girlfriend called, who traveled with me, and that was a check that it came. You know, you get those that hold the date checks.
Yeah.
So one of those that came and he needed some money. I said, well, that was her on the phone and I need to meet her to go get a check.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, all right. So I kind of packed a little small.
Something.
I was like, if I pack this big suitcase, that's going to be noticeable.
Right.
So I got a little something, put it in the truck and getting ready to roll off. And
you gave him the
pizza. He came to the car.
Okay.
So I kind of, because I was rolling off slow and I was like, what is it?
Right. Yes.
So we talked a little bit and then when I left, girl, I took the ring off and I threw it out the window. Right.
Praise God.
Yanked the necklace off, threw it out the window.
Praise God.
And about a month or so, I don't know what's going on, but you need to come home. What are you doing? I've done it. I'm not doing anything.
Yeah.
So, and we talked, and I told him, I can't live that kind of life, or, you know, that kind of stress.
I respect myself.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
My baby needs me. And what am I saying to her?
That's good.
You know, I don't want that cycle to be repeated through my daughter's life.
That's good.
So I had to get in the mirror again.
Yes.
Call me in the mirror, lady. Talking to the woman in the mirror. Yeah. Yeah. What are you saying to your child? Your daughter is watching you.
That's good.
She can't grow up feeling that this is the only kind of relationship or the only kind of men out there. It's some wonderful men out there.
That's good.
That love God and will love me the way God loves me.
That's good.
You know, and
that's
the kind of man she's gonna marry.
That's good.
God and I were gonna see to that.
Yeah. Right.
That's
oh,
good.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
Are you ready to love again? We gotta wrap this up. Are you ready to love
can
again?
Can the church see it? You're crazy. Save and rich. We don't have save, broke, and. And I'm
Amen.
Not playing about that.
That's right. That's right. Knows how to talk to you. Knows how to
yes.
treat you.
Yes.
Loves God.
Right. Because you're yeah. faithful to God, you're going to be faithful to me.
30 seconds. I want you to look into that camera back there, and I want you to tell every woman out there that's been hurt, that has went through it, that thinks that she can't bounce back. What do you have to say, Sean?
Don't let nobody stop you from loving. That's the first thing. Don't ever get that hurt that you stop loving.
Yes.
Love God, love the men, and respect them for who they are, because they are wonderful creatures created by God.
Right.
Love God, love yourself, get in the Word, become a prayer warrior.
Amen.
I mean, pray. Whatever time He wake you up in the morning, pray. Stay on your knees, stay in the Bible. You're better than that. You're God's queen.
Yes.
Sean.
Yes.
We're wrapping up. We're wrapping up. We're wrapping up. I need you to speak. You have endured so much pain.
Mm.
And there are sometimes points in which, you know, in someone's life that they feel that they've experienced so much pain that they can't go on.
My God.
Thoughts of suicide.
Yes.
Thoughts of, you know.
Goodness.
You've been there.
Yes.
Could you quickly speak to that and tell them that joy is coming?
Joy is coming, and not just in the morning. It's coming now.
Okay.
That's good. That's good. So hold on.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Respect yourself.
Yes.
We got enough God. We got enough scriptures. Get in the mirror and talk to yourself.
That's good.
Bring joy to you.
Amen.
By saying, I am beautiful.
Yeah.
I'm happy today.
Yeah.
You may be sad all on the inside. I'm happy. Mary Mary said, get in that mirror and say, I love me.
That's
and that's where it starts.
I love you so much.
I love you, girl.
Thank you for being here. You've inspired me. I'm going to start talking to myself in the mirror.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, LaShawn Pace.
Thank you.